You must have seen many steel structure where the built-up column is used instead of rolled section column. But why? Why rolled section is not used and why built-up section is used? Well, this video will answer you this question. Hi, I am Tanmay. Welcome to my channel. If you are a civil engineer and new to this channel, please subscribe to get videos on analysis, design and construction. So, if you have ever designed any steel column, you know that how the design strength is decreased when you increase the slenderness ratio of your column. I think you have already learned what is KL/R or slenderness ratio. If you don't know, in that case, you can watch it given in the description below. Here you can see, to utilize the material at max, you need to reduce or you need to keep your KL/R value to the minimum level. But for any given column, we have nothing to do with the effective length or KL. But yes, we can play with the radius of gyration or R. How? We know that radius of gyration or R is expressed by this formula. And our R value can be increased for constant cross-sectional area or A if we increase the I or the moment of inertia. Now, how the I value or the moment of inertia about any axis can be increased? Well, if you distribute the material away from the axis, moment of inertia will increase and eventually your radius of gyration will also increase. Here you can see about this axis, I is more in this case compared to this one. Why? Because here the materials are distributed more far away from the axis comparing to this one. And again, if you compare these two sections, here the moment of inertia for this section is more. Remember, for all these three cases, the cross-sectional area is constant or same. So, we can increase the value of the R by increasing the value of I as we wish. Isn't it? No, we can't. Why? You can see here, the thickness of this section is very thin compared to this one. So what happened? When you load it axially compressed load, it will buckle locally. Now what is the meaning of local buckling? Till now, we have tried to resist this global buckling or the general buckling of the column by reducing the slenderness ratio or the KL/R value. And we are successful in doing so, but our material has buckled locally. In our case, the cross section was rectangular. So, when it buckles locally, it will look like this. Here you can see, let's say the compressive loads were applied like this from top and from the bottom. Instead of buckling generally or in this form, it has buckled locally. Why? Because the thickness of the element has been reduced too much to increase the value of our radius of gyration. That's why the rolled section are produced with limited value of radius of gyration, and the basis of this limitation is local buckling. Now, if you have a long column with intermediate load, to design it, you have two options. First one is, use a rolled section where KL/R or slenderness ratio is high, and that's why the design strength is very much less. So, to bear the load with less design strength, you need a large cross-sectional area. And the second option is, use a built-up section where you can place your material in such a manner that the R is maximum or the KL/R is less or the design strength is maximum. So naturally, the requirement of cross-sectional area is less. So which one is economical? Obviously, the second one or this built-up column section. That's the reason why we use built-up section for long column. Now, you have placed the component of your built-up column at the desired place. Now, who will connect them or who will keep them in place when they will be loaded? Yes, you know that lacing or batten is used for connecting them. Here you can see that this four angle has been connected in all four sides. In the plan, this looks like this, but if you see in elevation, in case of lacing, you can see like this, but in case of batten, you see like this. As you can see here that as component of the built-up section, the channel section has been used. In case of larger load, you can use the rolled I section as component of your built-up section, and then you can connect them by using lacing or batten. So, is it the only role of lacing and batten to keep the compressive member in place? No. Then what is the other function? Yes, you know that they carry the shear or shear and moment. But how this shear or moment come and how lacing or batten successfully carry them? Well, in the next video we will get the answer. Till then, think about it. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to subscribe it if you have not done yet.